evening. We're going to go ahead and get started because it is a little warm in here, as we've all noticed. And also, I know some of you are probably hanging out and ready for cookies and punch. But we have some important work to do first. I want to welcome you. I'm Todd Minnick with the Honeywell Foundation. And on behalf of the Honeywell Foundation and the partners here, we're really excited for this first of what we hope will be an annual Rochester Area Banner Competition. This started with the Honeywell Foundation 14 years ago. The Wabash Banner Competition has been going on 14 years, and Miami County celebrated its 7th anniversary, so we do hope this becomes an annual event. It started with a former Wabash mayor, Bob McCown, and his wife Peggy were on vacation out west, and they saw banners around downtown. And so Bob drove, and Peggy was hanging out the window taking photos of all these banners. And they immediately headed for City Hall to find the current mayor there to ask how this program came to be. And he brought this idea back to Wabash, and we were fortunate to be able to start this program in Wabash and expand, and that's what brings us here tonight. And so to recognize these wonderful artists for their amazing artwork tonight, I'm gonna turn it over to the Director of Education and Outreach for the Honeywell Foundation, Teresa Galley, to present the awards.
Thanks so much. As Todd shared, we're thrilled to continue growing this annual banner competition and the family of counties that participate. It's been amazing to work with the three superintendents, the many staff members in the school districts, as well as the many community members who have helped this become a reality this evening. So to begin the night, we would like to recognize all of the grade level winners who were selected by their schools to be submitted to the competition. The artwork was amazing, and you'll see when we show the 20 winners in just a bit that while those 20 are incredible, we had a very difficult decision. We probably could have easily picked 50 or 60 winners from this competition. They were amazing. So students, as I call your name, if you are a finalist from your school, you may come forward to either set of stairs, and Psi Io Design members Kim Benzing and Rachel Steffen will give you your ribbon. We do not ask you to hold applause. Clap for your kids. So, from Caston Elementary, Marissa Ennis, Remington Correct, and Ella Sylvain, our kindergartners. First graders, Lila Gebhardt, Gracie Jacobs, and Logan Mollenkamp. Second graders, Elijah Holloway, Eli Sylvain, and Gage Thomas. Third graders, Avery Baldwin, Savannah Moss, and Brianna Rangel. Fourth graders, Cora Burns, Joshua Evans, and Madeline Sprout. Fifth graders, Brooklyn Borges, Annie Harsh, and Olivia Paul. And sixth graders, Nevea DeFilippo, Jonathan Pachenko, and Emma Kay. From Caston Junior Senior High School, Catherine Katie Kress, Elizabeth Pierce, and Byron Rinchler, 7th grade. 8th graders, Bryn Burnett, Deanna Hoff, Brianna Hubenthal, Talisha Lozier, Rebecca Milburn, and Jerica Sosa. 10th graders, Haley Hurt, Ryan McVeigh, and Sydney Smith. 11th grade, Hannah Hoover, and seniors, Brianna Florida, and Allie Roush. from Columbia Elementary School, Corbin Boldry, Olivia Byers, and Talia Listenberger, all in kindergarten. First graders, Sophie Beeler, Megan Kreft, and Molly Moore. And second graders, Isaac Heishman, McKenna McKee, and Chloe Wynn. From Riddle Elementary School, Brady Gamble, Haley Rubio, and Violet Whitmer, third grade. Madeline Coble, Brady Morgan, and Brock Wilson, fourth grade. Haley Coleman, Taylor Howard, and Shaylee McLeod Garnett, fifth grade. From Rochester Middle, Madeline Calloway, 7. Brianna Small, 7. And Zeta Whitmer, 7. And parents, I see some of you have caught on. We fully encourage being paparazzi. So snap pictures, there are no flash restrictions this evening. We know how proud you are of your students. From Rochester High School, Ava Kennedy, Addie Harsh, and Mackenzie Wood, ninth grade. Emma Campbell, Lexi Galbraith, John Tay Harper, 10th grade. Xavier Ivan, Corey Roush, and Aubrey Willard, 11th grade. Kennedy Campbell, Samantha Jolly, and Alexis Jolly, seniors. From Akron Elementary, Carter Bainey, Chloe Homan, and McKenna Wright, kindergarten. Africa Baca, McKinley Burton, and Liam Newcomer, first grade. Riley Gonzalez, Adeline Jordan, and Taylor Long, second grade. Evan Burkholder, Bricklin Hall, and JC Ramirez, third grade. Reese Rinsberger, Jonas Scott, and Elise Smith, fourth grade. Grant Kaufman, Zoe Miller, and Ani Ramirez Brito, fifth grade. From Mentone Elementary, Colette Frenzel, Lauren Martin, and Kaylin Thompson, kindergarten. Oh, one more. And Callaway Waldo, kindergarten also. First graders, Kenley Crabb, Kinley Koch, Dirks Miller, and Bella Newcomer. Second grade, Bailey Anderson, Zane Helms, Cheyenne Kuhn, and Brody Harp. And, oh, Brody Harp is third grade. Kira Kaiser, Landon Patrick, and Lola Vick from third grade. Fourth grade, Colton Crabb, Rayleigh Hughes, Amber Klossener, and Madison Thompson. And fifth graders, Cody Eastgate, Madison Grossman, and McKenna Rentschler. From Tip Valley Middle School, Jada Conley, Kennedy Kohler, and Carissa Sloan, sixth grade. Marissa Cauldron, Emma Howard, and Ariana Lewis, seventh grade. And from Tippecanoe Valley High School, Maida Fear, Luis Hernandez, and Kirsten Yoder, ninth grade. Shaylee Shriver, Camille Yoakum, and Corey, just two 10th graders. I'm sorry, Camille Yoakum, 10th grade. you get in a rhythm sometimes. You, Corey Sebastian, Kaylee Shoemaker, and Lee Stouter, 11th grade. And seniors, Audrey Jackson and Gracie Schwinger. We'd now like to recognize the banner winners. When I call your name, please come to the stage to accept your award and stay on stage because we're gonna do a little picture taking. Parents, feel free to take some pictures as well. We'd like all of you, regardless of where you're sitting, to come on stage on this side, accept your award, and then come to the center. And we're gonna hold you here and do a few poses before we move you on. So we'll have our grade level banner selections first. They represent the best overall design as selected by our judge from students in grades kindergarten through 12th grade. And you will see your banner on the screen as I call your name. From Caston Elementary, Marissa Ennis, kindergarten. And teachers, if they don't make it, if you'd come up on stage and grab their awards before you leave tonight, we'd appreciate that. From Columbia Elementary, Megan Kreft, first grade. From Caston Elementary, Gage Thomas, second grade. And it's on our program, but I didn't mention our theme this year is Our Beautiful Earth. And so you're about to see 20 different takes on what that means to the kids. And I thought they did an amazing job. From Mentone Elementary, Brody Harp, third grade. Okay. Gage, stay here with us. Okay. Oh, can we go back one?
Thank you.
Okay. Perfect. And then, can we have you, hey buddy?
Gage, can we have you wait over here? We're gonna do a group shot at the end, okay?
Hold tight for us for just a minute. Okay. If anybody else has come up from this group, come back. Okay, Mentone Elementary, Amber Klusener, fourth grade. From Riddle Elementary, Taylor Howard, fifth grade. From Tippecanoe Valley Middle, Jada Conley, sixth grade. Jada, wait for us just over here, okay? From Rochester Middle, Madeline Calloway, seventh grade. Yes. Wait for us right here. Right. From Caston Junior Senior High, Deanna Hoff, Rebecca Milburn, and Jerrica Sousa from eighth grade, these girls came together and did a group project to create one banner. So come on. Two of the three.
Congratulations. Is that good? one more.
We'll have you wait over here for the group shot, okay? From Rochester High School, Addie Harsh, ninth grade. Not here, okay. From Rochester High School, Emma Campbell, 10th grade. You have Emma? Yes. Okay. Now we know who brought her fan club. Okay. We saw you trying to bypass that line. Okay, and stay here with the group. From Rochester High School, Corey Roush, 11th grade. Nope, okay. And also from Rochester High School, Kennedy Campbell, senior, 12th grade. Here, Kennedy. Yes, okay. Okay, and so now we're going to bring you all over, you know, and we can leave this banner up. Do you want them to kind of?
If they go over there, then that's on their face. Can we go over here?
Sure. Over here?
Absolutely.
Yeah. She's gonna. Can we move? Maybe you three in the front.
Yeah.
Can you three jump in the front? You need to hop on the end, probably in front.
Tracy, you're going to stand right there between the two girls?
The podium's there.
Go with Todd.
Go with Todd. What does that mean?
There you go. Good. Everybody's looking right here. I'm going to take them all. Big smiles. Good. Big smiles. Good. Okay. Let me get you.
Amazing work. We warned you it is. All right. Our next category is best of show selections. To avoid missing the chance to celebrate the work of our younger students, we did split this into four categories based on a combination of the students' grades, grade levels. So our winners are, and again, enter from this side. Come on over. You just saw how it all works. Best of show kindergarten through third grade, Violet Whitmer, third grade, from Riddle Elementary. Come on down. Will you hang out right here for just a minute? Okay. Best of show winner, grades 4 through 6, Ani Ramirez Brito, fifth grade from Akron Elementary. Wait, right here? Okay. Best of show, grades 7 through 9, Ariana Lewis, seventh grade from Tippecanoe Valley Middle School. So many interpretations of the theme. I love it. right here with me for just a minute. And best of show grades 10 through 12, Alexis Jolly, Rochester High School. Okay, we're gonna bring you three back over to pose as a group now. So just, oh wait, were we doing it here? Yes, true. We realized if the picture projects on you, your face is all kinds of crazy. And the members of Psi Iota Xi's Banner Committee had the opportunity to select our Sponsor's Choice Award winners. Sponsor's Choice, kindergarten through sixth grade, Jonathan Pacheco, sixth grade, Caston Elementary. Jonathan here. Yay. Jonathan, did I say that right? Stay right here with us for just a minute. Our Sponsor's Choice winner, 7th through 12th grade, Kirsten Yoder, 9th grade from Tippecanoe Valley High School. Oh, here. Nope. Okay. All right. You can go. We got you. All right. Thank you, sir. Great work. And finally, all of the judges came together to select one final piece, our Best Use of Theme Award. And the winner in this final category is Hannah Hoover, 11th grade from Caston Junior Senior High School. We have Hannah here. Mm-hmm. Oh. Thank you. The work created by these talented young artists will hang in downtown Rochester on the light poles for the next several months. I know everyone will just love taking family and friends downtown to enjoy the art, and we hope that they'll brighten up the streets the entire summer season. But I want you all to know that this program would not have come together without the hard work and the excitement of one amazing woman. To share a little bit about how we all ended up here today, please welcome Betty Martin.
Well, actually, when she sent me the program and it said catalyst for something, and I thought, I've been called a lot of things, but not a catalyst before. But that's okay. I thought that was a great word. Just a quick background. I know the cookies and punch are waiting, and we're all getting anxious about that. But how this happened was basically I was driving through Wabash about a year ago in maybe February or March, and drove by the Honeywell Center, and if you ever get a chance to go down there during the winter time, they have these, oh, they're still up.
And, no.
Oh, new ones,
we
they have new ones.
This year.
That's right.
Yeah.
And there were these beautiful banners, and it said so-and-so from Metro North, and so from Northfield, and I thought, how did they do that? So I'm retired, I don't do anything all day. So I stopped and actually had a conversation and met Teresa for the first time, and from that, came several different meetings. I talked to the Downtown Design Committee because they were formulating a plan to apply for grants for new light poles and things like that. I talked to the fire chief because usually the fire department puts things up on the light poles. Then I talked to the clerk treasurer, and I talked to the mayor, and I talked to all these people, and then I got to meet with the superintendents and the principals and the art teachers themselves. And so really it was just kind of a snowball effect, and I hope that the art teachers and I hope that the parents feel like this was well worth your time and effort. I know maybe you didn't have a lot to do with it because they did probably, I think, probably most of the work at school, which means of course most of the teachers. But at the same time, I want to thank a few people before we go on. On behalf of the AMU chapter of Psi Iota Xi, I thank you for all coming tonight. This whole project has been a true collaborative effort between a lot of different entities. First, of course, the Honeywell Foundation and the McCallum family for starting this whole endeavor so many years ago. And encouraging and embracing arts on a large scale is something that doesn't happen a lot of times, especially in small communities. So we really appreciate the fact that their family was interested in this and that the foundation was able to partner with people to make it happen. And we are excited to add Rochester to the list of Wabash and Peru to have this art contest going on. Thank you also to the Community Foundation because we applied for and received a community support grant to help us fund the project. Also, I want to explain, Psi Iota Xi is a sorority, but many pictures that enter in your head when you hear the word sorority, just can't take those out of your head. Our sisterhood is quite different than that, and when I talk about joining Psi Iota with other people, other women, I characterize it as a group of women who raise money to give it away. And that's exactly what we try to do. At our monthly meetings, we recite an opening verse. It includes the words, "I believe in furthering charitable enterprises, in studying the best art, literature, and music, and developing myself morally, intellectually," and we'll just stop there. But anyway, art is one of our four major focuses of our philanthropy, along with music, literature, and speech and hearing projects. And through our annual fundraising projects like sales of flowers, which are going on right now, cheese balls and things, we allocate in the Rochester area about $10,000 a year in donations, not just projects like this, but other things. And when I pitched this idea to the members about a year ago, they were thrilled with the idea of giving students the opportunity to share their artwork with a very wide audience. As I was telling earlier, I said, you know, most of the time when you want to see students' artwork, you have to go in the school or you have to go in a library or you know, there's a very narrow window to see student artwork. So having these banners up in the town, in the city, will be a great opportunity to do that. As a matter of fact, we plan on keeping the work, the banners, and that's the reason the students received a copy, because we want next year to hang 40 banners up. We want to hang the 20 from this year and have 20 more for next year, and then add more streets and add more banners, and that's the idea behind it. So at this time, I also want to thank a few people. I'd like for all the art teachers to stand for the moment. I'm going to ask you to come up later, but would you all stand, any of the art teachers that are here today? As with all things, and being a retired teacher, I know nothing can happen without the teachers in the classroom. So through your willingness to include this contest in your curriculum and work with the students and take care of the management aspects, we had over 120 pieces of art to judge. We can't thank you enough for your efforts on that, on our behalf for this contest. Are there any administrators in the audience from Caston or Valley or Rochester? I know there's one, because she's my good friend. And there's one over there, yay, and Scott. Oh, there's three. Good. Oh, there's Mr. Boggs. Okay. Oh, and there's one over there. Good for you. Anyway, we are so excited that the administrators fully endorse the idea of having this contest, and we're willing to have their teachers participate and their students, and really appreciate the opportunity to get into the schools and hopefully continue this for many years. And next, I think last, I would like to thank the downtown merchants and the design committee for embracing the idea of having this part of their downtown. And I would like to introduce, on behalf of the city, oh, I want to thank also Shada Beeler, the clerk treasurer, who happens to be here. Lenny Comley, who's the street department superintendent, who forgot as of yesterday that they're hanging these up soon. But I'm sure he'll remember when they end up in his office. And also Tom Butler, the fire chief, because all of those people helped formulate this idea of how we could hang them and so forth. So I appreciate that. Also the people who helped that are in the program, Hardesty's and the Ribbons and Rosettes, and our own Rachel Stephen that designed this wonderful invitation and so forth. So I thank them. And at this time, I'm going to invite the mayor, Ted Denton, to come up to the stage and hopefully receive the banners on behalf of the city. So thank you very much, and here's Ted Denton.
sweating, Betty.
No, it's not hot in here.
Thank you, Todd, Teresa, and of course my love, Betty. Betty and I, we've been married, by the way, before. We've been on stage together as husband and wife. Boy, that didn't last long. Thank you all for coming out tonight. And I do accept these banners on behalf of the city of Rochester. And you named my team that such a great team. We'll make sure they get hung, won't we? They'll be up. And it's really, really important that we do these things. We honor the arts. I don't know how many of you know this, but my degree is in the arts. Yeah, I try to keep that quiet because everybody thinks, oh, you got to have a business degree to do what you're doing. Art is who we are. Art is part of all of us. The one thing that came to mind as I was watching all these beautiful banners being displayed, and by the way, they all ought to be framed, don't you think? Yes, yes, they're gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. But the one thing that kept coming to mind was how unique each and every one of them were. And I'll tell you why that is. That's art, ladies and gentlemen. Whether it's theater art, whether it's vocal art, whether it's dance, whether it's sculpture, painting, whatever. Art is very unique to the artist. You didn't see any banner that looked like one of the other banners up here. They were all a piece of the artist. It's the same thing with all the arts. So it's so important that we keep doing this because it tells a story of who we are. So I am very, very pleased to be here tonight. This has been a great gathering. And congratulations to all of you young contestants. Congratulations to all of the art teachers, to the administrators. And thank you, Sciotes. I love the Sciotes. Aren't they wonderful? They're all about art. They're all about art. They're keeping it alive, and I love it. Thank you for Rochester. And thank you from the mayor of Rochester.
After Todd makes this announcement, then I'd like for the art teachers to come that are here to come down to the front because I need to talk to you just a little bit. Okay?
So that was a public service announcement. We are to the conclusion of this part of the awards and the program. I just want to thank everybody that participated to do this, but especially to all of the artists out here. So one more round of applause for all of our student artists. Great. So, on that round of applause, let's all adjourn to the cafeteria for cookies and punch to continue celebrating.